Hey folks, René Molenaar here for GNS 3Volt. I want to show you the OSPF Virtual Link Lab. So, what are you going to learn in this lab? If you look at this OSPF network, you can see that area 0 is what we call discontinuous, so it's not connected anymore. On top we have area 0 and at the bottom. So we need a virtual link to fix that. And you can also see that area 2 is behind area 1. That's not going to work, so we need a virtual link to fix that. So let's see what we have to do. Configure OSPF and then fix the discontinuous backbone area 0 and make sure area 2 has connectivity to the backbone. So let's start and I'll show you how we have to do this. First of all, let's configure the backbone, area 0. And that should be area 1 for router chicken. That's router beef. That's all in area 1. There we go. Router pork has a loopback in area 0. And something in area 1. And there is router fish. And it has a loopback in area 2. And this one in area 1. Okay. So first of all, we should fix the connection between router chicken and router pork. Let's create a virtual link for that. Okay, so I do have two OSPF neighbors, or three of them on router beef. Let's set up the virtual link. You have to configure the area for the virtual link. And that's the area where you have to travel through in order to reach the other end. And you have to specify the neighbor, but not the IP address, but the router ID. So, what do we have here? Area 1 virtual link. There we go. And you can see that we now have a neighbor. OSPF VL0, that's virtual link 0, is ready. And you can see that router pork now has learned about the network of router chicken. Yeah. Hi. Erik. Ik kom eraan. Doei. You can see that we have a neighbor adjacency through the virtual link. So that's all good. That's working. And now there's one more thing that we have to do. And that's to make sure that router fish has a virtual link to the backbone area. Now you can create a virtual link towards router chicken or towards router pork. Doesn't matter which one, I'm going to create it towards router chicken. As long as it's connected to the backbone, it's all good. Here we go. There we go. We have a virtual link. And as you can see, we just learned about the loopback of router fish. And that's it. This is an example of a virtual link and also the end of this lab. If you are studying for your CCIE and you have to solve a problem like this, but you are not allowed to use a virtual link, then you can also solve this problem by using GRE tunnels. That's another method of doing it, but the virtual link is of course the best one, because it's a native OSPF solution. Anyway, thanks for watching, I hope you enjoyed this, and if you did, make sure to check out some of my other OSPF labs. For now, thanks for watching.